Hi friends, this is Shelley Tomic with Pitch Publications. I'm going to talk today about how to update text in an editable product, specifically in PowerPoint. In my resource, the Patriotic Sing Along, I've done most of the work for you for any song that I knew was in the public domain, but there are a few songs that unfortunately I cannot include the lyrics for due to copyright restrictions, but it's super easy for you to get them in there. I've also recently updated it with a completely editable version, so if you sing slightly different lyrics, feel free to edit them directly. I've also included the font that was free to include in the resource. I've used a really simple font called Josephine Sans. When you download your product under resource files, you'll actually see the folder called Josephine Sans Install Me. It's super easy to install. I'm on a Mac, but it works the same on the PC. Usually you just double click it and it's gonna open up in either font book or the Windows version, and you just install the font right there. And there's several different versions because this is a really flexible font that allows you to be bold or italic or a combination, and you can just enter that right in there. Now, if you install the font and then you go back to PowerPoint and the font is not appearing, close out PowerPoint, restart your computer, and then it should appear okay. So I've come to one of the songs that I could not include lyrics for, 50 Nifty United States by Ray Charles. Love this song, one of my favorites, one of my kids' favorites. I've already inserted a text box in the editable version, but just in case that you don't have a text box, undelete that. Or you're working with a different resource, it's so easy to do. You can use the text box up on the ribbon, that's what this menu is called, or you can actually go to insert and do insert text box. And then you can just draw it right there. And once there, you can just type your text as normal. Now, obviously it's gonna be whatever your default font is, so you're gonna wanna go home. And if you wanna match it, you can just type in Josephine Sans and it'll pull right up. Thought it would be just a little bit easier if I went ahead and had a text box that was already pre-formatted. Now I'm gonna show you how to copy and paste text and keep the formatting that's already set up for you here. I went ahead and I just Googled the lyrics to 50 Nifty United States, AZ Lyric, you know, one of the websites that you can find lyrics on. A lot of these lyric sites actually have deals with the publishing companies to display the lyrics like this. But I know I'm going to use just the first couple of lines here, so I'm going to highlight that. I'm going to copy. I'm going to go back to PowerPoint. If I didn't have this text box here already formatted, it wouldn't actually keep the formatting. So if I just went here and went to just right-clicked and went edit paste, you'll see it actually is going to format with the font or the closest thing to the font it can find from the website. And then I have to go back and individually format each of those. So I don't want to do that. Instead, what I'm going to do is highlight this text here. And then most of the time you can just right click and paste and it's going to keep the same formatting there. If for some reason that doesn't work, you do have some paste options. If you use keep source formatting, you'll see that it keeps the format from the website. So instead, you want to do either like keep text only or use destination theme, because that's saying, hey, I want to use the formatting that was already there. Now, you're still going to have to kind of size it a little bit. For example, I'm going to spread this out and I might go ahead and do a line break. To do a line break, I'm clicking shift and enter. I might do another line break right there. And it's up to you whether you want to capitalize at the beginning of your line or not. So I'm there. You do have to do a little formatting, which is a little bit hard. If you're trying to grab this text box and you keep moving the background, just make sure you're kind of directly over it. I usually will click on the text and then click the line to make sure I grab that. So you're just gonna repeat that for each side. I know that that's gonna cost you a little bit of time and I do apologize for that, but I'm trying to respect the copyrights of others. Feel free to email me at shelley@pitchpublications.com and I'll be happy to help you out or answer any questions I can. Have a wonderful day.